to recognize everybody who has given me this opportunity. The people who sat down to choose who deserve to have this award. I know there are many people. When my CEO, Ms. Eunice Asango, called me, I was in Monaco. And she finished Jackson from UNHCR, he called. Another person again from UNHCR, he called. We are also going to present our people, and we are presenting you. The other agencies also from UN, they were presenting theirs. I have also worked with UNDP, with UNICEF. I think with everybody, the last person that now we are working together at the UNHCR. I think that's where my call, and for everybody from other agencies looking for, is because of the refugees. Otherwise, you could not be called by the UN. And then I told them, okay, good luck. How many people are candidates? And they came, all the big names. And I say, no, good luck. I don't think I will have a chance. But I will congratulate the person who will win. The time goes by. And I just want to say thank you. This award, I'm not taking it just for granted. And before I forget, this award will go to three stages. That's our refugees athlete, gender, our warriors, reformed warriors that we started since 2003. I dedicate this award to them. And also, we shared a gold medal in Rio that came from judo. That was a Brazil athlete, but because our coach was a coach for that judo, they said the refugee got the medal. And the Brazil country said, okay, we have to divide. So I also recognize the IOC for opportunity. It has been a long journey, and I want to congratulate especially the people who make all the team for our people to be selected for the Rio. The athletes that went to Rio, they were supported for those with the athletes at the state. And also I want to thank my government for hosting the refugees. I am proud to be a Kenyan. And that's when I talked with Rolf in Qatar. And that's when the time, everything was very hot. I say, I have managed along the borders of Karamojong cluster and our region. And the fire went down. Also, the refugees come, they have issues. Can we do it? Can I offer myself? My brother ambassador said, don't expect what the country can do for you. What can you do also for the country? What can you do to make a difference? And that's when I went to the United Nations. I said, I'm not part of the United Nations, but I'm part of the country. I can contribute as you contributed since I started the project, Tegla Chepkite Peace Foundation. I've been supported by the UN. What can I do to make a difference? I know I've worked with my brother. When I did not have money, I had to call him all the time because I know him. Thank you so much. I want to congratulate and thank also my brother from the community of Muslims. And I want to also pay my tribute to the people who lost their lives. The people we call criminals, they're our sons. I think we need to use another diversity to empower those people also to disarm their minds, to realize that it's not all about the money that makes you a hero. It's all what you can contribute to do something good, to protect the blood. We as women, if we can also try to talk to our children. It's very painful for us to start pointing our fingers. It's us, at the end of the day, a woman can cry. Why can we also try to make races for these people? And tell them, can you own something? We will have also people who can we can discern their mind in a better way. A can will never solve a problem. It will contribute more problems. I talk this because when we started in 2003, the Tegla Loroupe Peace Foundation, Peace Race, we had to go to the community to talk. I remember going with Eunice to a place close to Pokot and Marquette. There was a small kid in a class. I will not go long. And he was busy doing his own things. We asked, why you don't listen to us? He said, I'm studying. What are you doing? I'm doing, something. Because I want to calculate. Tomorrow, I'm going to kill all the Pokot because they killed my family. This is a very small kid, standard three. I asked, you know what, but I am also one of the, no, you are the best, you are the only one. You are a good person. I say, I'm part from that community. I talk with this kid, and they say, okay. So I can be somebody to be a pet ambassador. I say, you can be somebody. So that hatred will kill our generations. I just want to say, let's work together to see that our people doesn't fight. We don't want to see more refugees. It doesn't help us. We want to see our refugees going back home to be ambassadors. I want to see people like poor who went to United Nations to go to be a minister for sports in his country, to disarm the mind of youths. But the United Nations, you can help these people together with a country who has host them like Kenya. I want to tell you when I was in Rio, I do not know how I was getting messages from refugees, some from the people of Sudan, in Sudan itself, say, thank you, my sister, because you make us proud. Those people are running for the IOC under United flag and IOC. But they are our blood. We are so proud. Already we have disarmed the mind of those people. Thank you for the contribution. Thank you for the work that the UN you are doing. Let's support education. Let's support all the children. Let's try to use diplomatic talks to those who are killing security forces. Those are our brothers. Let's use another way. Sometimes we have to be stupid. You know, you are not a stupid person, but we have to calm down so that we can disarm the mind of the people. Let's use sports. And we need all your support so that we can expand this project. The Tokyo are looking forward to have a better legacy. So, United Nations, through your agencies like UNSI, congratulations for a wonderful work. It wasn't my ideas alone. Without your support, without the support of the government, I couldn't do it alone. Together, I think we can make a difference. Finally, to the media, try also to talk about positive things that even the UN doing, even the other agencies are doing, even the government are doing. We are building this nation or this continent together. When you encourage somebody, even a bad person, and you do something little, let's see the light. Let us not see the whole big darkness side. It will make our people, it makes us be a strong people. For me, when I get this award, I get more strong. I realize, oh, so there is somebody who cares for me. There is somebody who sees the effort that I'm doing. It makes you to move one step. I was in the Van de Milia in Monaco, between the French border and Monaco. I was able to feed 800 refugees. I never fed 800 in 3 hours. I went totally out. But these kids said, you know what? It is time to go back. It's time to go back and make a difference like what you are doing. So let's be example to where we are. Thank you so much, and may God bless you.
Take a picture.